I was reading here, doctor, there are two different types of sleep apnea. If you could educate us, please. Obstructive sleep apnea, central sleep apnea. What are the differences?
So the most common form of sleep apnea that we're concerned about, only because it's the most common, is what's called obstructive sleep apnea, which is kind of what I described. The muscles of the throat relax in the deepest stage of sleep, which all our muscles relax. You're breathing in, you close off the airway, you have to generate a higher pressure in the chest to pop that airway open, and that's obstructive sleep apnea. And that's associated with the body trying to breathe against a closed airway. Mm. There's another less common, probably less than 1 out of 20 of people who have sleep apnea, less than 5%, and that's called central sleep apnea. And that's something in the brain where the brain does not stimulate the lungs to breathe. So it's the same type of apneic lack of breathing episodes where you're not breathing, your oxygen level drops, but there's no chest movement. You're not trying to breathe. It's much less common. It's usually seen in people with significant neurological disorders, like they've had a stroke or Parkinson's or severe congestive heart failure. So central sleep apnea is usually not the one we're concerned about for the general population. Not to say it's not very important and leads to significant medical problems for those that have it, but just based on the numbers, it's the obstructive sleep apnea that we're really trying to get out to both the doctors to recognize and the population to recognize.